Yeah. I've heard different comments about this next song. A lot of questions. A lot of rumors get started. Some are true, some are bullshit. But I guess that's Hollywood. Anyway, I've seen a lot of my friends, a lot of close friends, end up in $15,000 rehab centers. I've seen them have to go in 2 or 3 times. Now, I don't got anything against partying with whatever you can find. But man, use your head and keep your ass alive. Cause you're the only one who's really gonna fucking look out for your own ass. And I've seen a couple friends go, and I don't wanna see it happen no more. So you be careful next time you go dancing with Mr. Brownstone.
Yeah.
got nonstop feedback in my monitor. You hear that? Last night, I got into a little hassle at the cat house with a singer in another band who has a problem. I won't tell you his name, but he's one of these people that thinks he's a rock star. That kind of thinking is a fucking crock of shit. I mean, I lived on these fucking streets for about 7 fucking years, and I'm just like you. That's all there is to it. You know, you don't need this ego bullshit. They make a bad name for people just trying to fucking do their job and do what they like. They can fuck it up for everybody else. These kind of people, man, they're just as good as the people that fucking tell you how long to wear your hair, what you should wear, and what you should do, and what kind of job you should have. They all should get in a fucking boat and float straight to hell, as far as I'm concerned. These kind of people make me feel like someone out there is out to get me. This is a hard song for me to do right now. I wrote this for someone that I care the world about. You ever know someone that you used to love, but your lives change and you wonder why and what happened? And when you reach that point in your relationship, you didn't know where to go. Well, when I wrote this song, I didn't know that it would be a self-fulfilling prophecy and it would actually happen. But for anyone that knows me or knows my friend Aaron, this is a sweet child of mine. So, I think that'll lead right into this next song. Something Izzy and I wrote. Making fun of songs that about how bad some woman treated a man. As Sam Kinison said, I think this goes for men as well as women. Got to drink that six pack of Heineken just to keep from chopping her head off. Hey, I know I'm an asshole. It's okay. There's a little song called I Used to Love Her, But I Had to Kill Her. Fucking real stations in the fucking world. We'll do this song for them. This is kind of like that little ditty about smack. This is a little ditty about cocaine called My Michelle. Thank you. We'd like to thank all the opening bands. I wasn't saying nothing. That's why. We'd like to thank the opening bands that helped us out with these four shows. TSOL, Junkyard, LA Guns, and tonight, Funhouse. Hey, relax. Come on, guys. Give them a fucking break. Right now, we're going to dedicate this song to every girl here who doesn't mind the cold. She's going to show off what she's got because she's proud of it. This is for every true red-blooded bitch out there. You know, I'm talking about a rocket queen. We'll be right back. people been to a few of these shows lately? Anybody at the show we did with the cold in Long Beach? Anybody here know Todd Crew? This song we do up for our friend Todd. If anybody out there is having a friend who was in a car accident or OD'd or something happened and you lost him, maybe in a war or something, Vietnam buddy, I don't know. And you know what it feels like. Give you a break, shut the fuck up. See, you know, I'm very lucky to be here. About 3 months ago, I OD'd and ended up in Cedars-Sinai. 20 volumes, 4 Nebutals, and a bottle of Jim Beam. All I wanted to do was sleep for the weekend. I wasn't planning no permanent vacation. But anyway, the first person I saw when I got out of the hospital was my friend Todd. And he gave me a hug and he said, "You can't do this to the family." Kind of surprised the shit out of me, and then 2 weeks later he OD'd. So this is a song called "Knockin' on Heaven's Door," and I'd like to get your help in singing some of it. I dedicate this to getting through life any way you fucking can. Don't hassle him for the lighters, guys. Don't hassle him for the lighters. Come on. I can't use it anymore. right here. So I'd like to see this place kick the last three nights ass. I'll tell you if you didn't do it.
Alright, I got a big fucking cool buddy of mine over here. I fucked myself up. I gave him a call. I said, yo, Freddie, you gotta help me out over here. So there's a lot of fucking cool rock and roll people out here that want to fucking hear Guns N' Roses, and I can't go out there and give them 100% of me. So I don't want to do that. So I called my friend Freddie up over here, and he says, fuck yeah, I'll do it. I said, thank you! So the rock and roll dude over here, this highly satanic motherfucker from hell. Come on, let me hear from fucking Fred Curry. Thank you! Freddie! You rock my world, dude. Thank you. Hey, thank you guys.
take a minute to introduce the rest of the band. On the far guitar, Mr. Izzy Stradlin. On the bass, Mr. Duff, the King of Beers, McKagan. On the drums from the band Cinderella, Mr. Fred Curry. And over here. Calling from the nearest liquor store in hell. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Slash. Hey, fuckers!
Let me have some house lights. I can't see these people. So this is it, man. Fucking four shows in Los Angeles, man. You don't know how much this kicks fucking ass to be here. I haven't been doing any extended raps lately. I just want to listen, fucking thank everybody who fucking wanted to push the band when everybody else that was on the outside was going, oh, those guys are a bunch of fuck-ups and they can't do shit. You know? We fucking done all the shows, man, fucking like after hellacious fucking nights when we were fucking wasted. We made it the next morning to the show. We fucking played, you know? We did the best we fucking could every single night. You know, we managed to sell a few fucking records at the same time. So all those fucking people can just fuck off, right? So, alright, this one's for you guys, because it's like Los Angeles is where we started from, and you guys sort of put us on the map and shit. Yeah? Alright, so this is one of our fucking, you know, one of our I don't know how what you call it, sort of little thing we do, sort of in respect for how speed metal and shit, you know, so we do this song. And this is something that's dedicated to everybody, like I said, and the band and the crew and fucking the fucking Cat House and KNEC and all that shit. There's something called You're Fucking Crazy.
Pacific Concerts, Pacific Promotions, but putting this on. This is something that the boys been kind of working on. It's a little blues jam for you.
Thank you. little bit more organized now, right?
Thank you.
last song, I want to wish you a, hope you had a merry fucking Christmas and you have a happy fucking New Year. I know that you made the end of my year with something real fucking nice. This is a place I can now call Paradise City.
Down.
is a one-armed bandit, Steven. He's gonna do some drumming here, one-handed. Sorry it took us so long, I had to, how you say, bleed my lizard. This is something you probably, you know, won't really hear until next summer when it comes out on an EP called The Sex, The Drugs, The Violence, The Shocking Truth. This is something that the only time we've really had to rehearse it is when we've been playing it at these shows. The song we call Patience. Anybody got that here? You like Aerosmith? You want to talk to your fucking mother right now?